Last month featured a blowout jobs number, and we get December's numbers next week. Joining us now to discuss what to expect for this month and beyond, Tom Gimbel is founder and CEO at LaSalle Network. Tom, good morning.
Good morning. Good to be with you.
So since that pretty good jobs number for November reported this month, we did get a couple of weeks of unemployment claims that were a little bit higher than expected, obviously coming off extremely low levels. Does that change the complexion of the overall job market? Or are we still looking pretty tight?
No, it's really a fantastic economy. The jobs market is tight. There's more jobs, as everybody knows, for the first time than ever than there are active looking participants. And I just correct you on one thing, Andrew. It wasn't a pretty good number in November. It was a fantastic number in November.
Oh, you're correcting Mike there. So let's
not get into it.
You don't need to throw me under the bus like that. It's okay. Happy holidays.
Yeah. But you're right.
It was fantastic. And now we have a shortened retail month because of Thanksgiving being so late in November. But it's going to be another good December, and there's no reason to think that it's slowing down in 2020.
Within the job market, I mean, you've had this theme for a long time now. Employers have been complaining that they can't find suitable job candidates to fill their open positions. What areas seem like there's a particular mismatch, perhaps?
Well, there's always going to be the technology aspect. So as everything goes from being on your local network and a hard drive to being up in the cloud, technology is evolving. That's not going anywhere. Healthcare, as we have the baby boomers and the older population, you guys have heard this from me every time I'm on for years. Those two sectors are only going to be more in demand. The question is, A, do people want to do the job? B, do we have the people that have the skills, even if they want to do those jobs? But I was with my kids and nieces and nephews who are college age this over the holiday, and we were talking about the different areas. Sales continues to be something that people coming out of high school, the reason salespeople get paid a lot of money is because a lot of people don't want to do the job. Companies are hiring more salespeople now than I've ever seen in 25 years since I graduated from college. And we have a huge demand, which isn't usually going at this late in the economy cycle, but for back office, accounting, finance, and supply chain. And when those are being hired simultaneously with salespeople, it's really a strong signal for the jobs market.
And sales in what particular industries?
That's the fascinating thing. You pick. It's across the board. It's obviously healthcare. It's obviously technology. It's financial services, professional services. Happens to be in specialized retail. And when I say retail, I don't mean people who are ringing the cash register, but people who are selling for wholesale, selling into retail companies. There's just so much demand right now for good quality labor at all white-collar levels, not to mention the blue-collar levels, you know, stuffing the boxes, shipping them, doing the quote-unquote Amazon jobs that everybody's talking about as well.